गुड आफ्टरनून स्टूडेंट्स। हेलो,
गुड आफ्टरनून सर। गुड
आफ्टरनून सर। गुड आफ्टरनून सर।
सो
गुड आफ्टरनून।
आफ्टरनून सर।
सो नाउ वी विल स्टार्ट द मॉड्यूल वन ऑफ सीसीएनए। तो आज वी हैव डिस्कस अबाउट द सीसीएनए कोर्स करिकुलम। सीसीएनए इट इज डिवाइडेड इनटू फोर मॉड्यूल्स। वी हैव टू स्टार्ट विथ द मॉड्यूल वन, दैट इज इंट्रोडक्शन टू नेटवर्क्स। So what a network is, or if you are going for a network, what we understand the meaning of network. So any networking means it is a group or consisting of some members. The member may be a person, may be a device, or may be something. So whatever it may be, if the network, it is defines that it is consisting of something or some persons, some devices, or some of the data also. So basically, in a network, if you are going for the computer network, all we are familiar with the social networking, like emails. You are using nowadays WhatsApp, Telegraphs. So these are the some of the social networking sites in which we are connected to each other. So at the back end of each social network, one computer network is there, which is responsible for carrying our data from one device to other device. That means when you are sending a video or an image to your friend or to someone, so how the data is transferred from your PC or from your mobile to the other person who is located nearby you, or it is that person may be 100 kilometers away, 1000 kilometers away, or some other locations. How the data is reached at the destination or at the other end. So this, that means there is something behind this computer or mobile which carries our data from my device or my mobile to your mobile, if I am sending the data from my mobile to your mobile. So that network, first we have to understand what the network is and how it is connected. So basically, the function of a network is it is used for the purpose of communication. So what the communication means, that means we have to communicate. Maybe we can communicate over our voice by using the phones. Maybe we are communicating by writing something, by chatting something, by sending some images to you, by sending some videos to you. So these are the different types of media through which we can communicate from one person to other person. And if you're going for the computer network, a computer network consists of different types of devices which is responsible for carrying our data from one location to other location. Just I'm taking 1 minute break, so some call is coming. Students, due to some technical issues, I am connecting you after 5 minutes. There is some network issue in the college, so I am taking 5 minutes break. I'll connect you after 5 minutes. Sorry, students, for the interruption. We'll start now.
Yes, sir.
CRS, are you here?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
So we have to start the introduction to network. And basically, we have discussed about what is the communication over the network. So basically, in a network, it is a group which is consisting of some of the computer devices. So basically, if you are going for computer network, so in a computer network, the main purpose of a computer network is to communication or to communicate the data. The data may be your voice data, maybe your text data, maybe the image data, or it may be the video data, or any type of file we have to communicate from one device to other device. So basically, if you are going for the computer network, in a computer network, suppose I have a mobile and you have a mobile. I want to communicate through my WhatsApp. I am sending something to you, you reply me. So there is a communication between you and me. And at the same time, if I want to communicate simultaneously for multiple persons, so if you are going for a video conference or audio conference, at that case also it is possible to communicate between or among many peoples. So nowadays it is possible. So just like here also, it is an example. When we are using the Zoom platform, we are communicating the online classes, which is a platform, networking platform, through which I am able to take the class in a online mode. I don't know where you are. You are, suppose I am at Bhubaneswar, you are at Bhubaneswar or not, or you are at some other locations, then also we can communicate to each other. Okay, so this is the advantage of network. But here our purpose is we have to create a network, or how a network is created so that a communication will establish between the source and the destination, or between the sender and the receiver. So for this purpose, we have to just start the network. And when we are going for the network, as we know that network is used for exchange of communication. So basically, this, what is communication? Communication means exchange of information between two individuals or devices. And communication begins with a message or an information, as we have discussed in the previous class, because due to some difficulties, all the students are not able to participate. And here also that limitation we are not facing today, because we have 113 students now, but some of the students are absent. So I think they will join because we are starting and we have to discuss so many things in this CCNA. And mostly we have to go for the lab classes. So when we are going for a network, we have to know some of the basic terms in the network. These basic terms are, first term is the sender. What is the sender? So the message, it is the message where it initiates, or the message, the starting point of the message from where it starts moving. That person or device is called as the sender, or it is called as the source of the network communication. So from the person or from the system, the message starts or initiates, it is called as the sender. So sender initiates the communication, and it is also known as source of communication. The second term is receiver. So the sender sends the data, and it is sent to whom? So there is some destination or there is a particular person to whom I am sending the data. Because when we are sending the data without destination, you cannot send any data in computer network. So the person receives the data is called as the receiver, or at the device it is receiving the data, it is called as the receiver or destination. So basically receiver, it receives the data sent by the sender. So two things we are confirmed in a network. One is sender and second one is the receiver. Or one is called as the source, other one is called as the destination. So between source and destination, or sender and receiver, we have to communicate something. Suppose what I am speaking to you, that is, so I am the sender, you are the receiver. What I am sending to you, that is called as data. So data is the actual content which the sender sends to the receiver, or the actual content which is sent or exchanged. So this is the, this data may be a voice data, maybe text data or some image. So what we are exchanging between sender and receiver, that is called as data. So previously we know that sender and receiver. Now we are adding another third term, that is data. Sender, receiver, and data. So what I have to communicate, or what the sender will communicate, that is called as the data. So when I know three terms, sender, receiver, and data. But whenever I am sending the data from one point to other point, how the data will move from my point or my location to the destination location? So it is not going without density or with the help of any media. So for example, if you are taking the example of one roadway transportation, suppose I am at Bhubaneswar, I want to send some packet or some of the bags to Calcutta, then source point is Bhubaneswar, destination is Calcutta, and what I have to send my data are the bags or some of the packets. So what I have to send physically from Bhubaneswar to Calcutta, but when I have to transport it, I need one media. So what is the media? I have to transport it by truck or by bus. So truck or bus are the media which is carrying the data from one location to other location. So similarly in computer network, when the data is forwarded or sent from one location to other location, it requires one path which is called as the media. The medias are two types. We can use the physical media or wired media, as well as we can use the wireless media. So what are the physical media? What are the wireless media? There are different types and different categories also. We'll discuss in the next class about the details of media or medium. So medium is the path through which the message is sent. So I have three terms, sender, receiver, and data. Now I have added another term that is called as the media or medium. Then when the data is forwarded, just like in the road transportation, just I have given the example of transportation of some packets from Bhubaneswar to Calcutta. So I need by truck or bus, I have to send the data. But when I am sending the data through truck or bus, the truck or bus will move on the surface, or by road it will be transported. So when the truck is moving in a road, it obey some of the rules, just like traffic rules, speed limit, overtake rules. So some of the rules are have to observed and obeyed by the driver. Or when the movement of the truck is from one place to other place, so it follows some of the rules. Similar things when in the computer network, when we are sending some data from one device to other device, it follows some of the rules. And these rules are called as the protocols. The protocol is the rule which governs the entire communication process. So if you are not following some of the rule, what will happen? So generally in a road transport, if all the drivers, they will not follow the traffic rule, what will happen? More number of accidents will occur. So some of the lives we have to, there is some loss of the lives as well as some of the vehicles as well as some of the goods. Similarly, in this computer network, when we are transporting the data or we are forwarding the data from one location to other location, we have to follow the protocol or rule. If you are not following the rule, then accidents will be occur. That accidents in computer network, we are using another term for this purpose. It is called as collision. So more number of collision will occur if you are not follow the protocol, and the data will not reach at the destination location. So we have to follow some of the protocols. So basically nowadays we are familiar with Windows operating system, and we are also using some of the Linux platform, some other platforms are there, but mostly we are familiar with Windows platform. So in Windows platform, we are using a particular protocol. So basically it is not a single rule, it is a setup rule or it is a packet of rule. So that packet of rule is called as protocol suite. So basically in this protocol or protocol suite, we are using in Windows platform, mostly we are using TCP IP protocol. So we'll discuss, so in a network, when you're assigning some IP addresses, you have to assigning it through the TCP IP protocol. So once we are following the TCP IP protocol, so all the rules are present at that, or the TCP IP protocol, it is already developed and it is installed with, it is already installed when we are installing the operating system with the PC or laptop. So when we are installing the operating system like Windows 10, Windows 8, Windows 7, whatever you are installing on your system, when we are installing, that protocol suite is inbuilt with that operating system. So we are, there is no necessary to add the protocol suite. Once again, you have to add. Already, if you have operating system, it is with the operating system. Only we have to choose the IP address through which we have to assign the IP address to that particular device. So details we'll discuss how to assign the IP addresses. The next, out of these terms, sender, once again, I am repeating, sender in a network, we are using these terms, sender, receiver, data, medium, and protocol. These five terms are the commonly used terms in a network. Any doubt, students?
No, sir.
No, sir.
No. Are you listening or just on the device and sleeping?
Listening, sir.
Listening, sir.
Listening, sir.
Listening, sir.
Okay. So, okay, next we have to discuss some other terms which we are using in this network, computer communication, or network communication. So that is another term is called as the segmentation. So why, what is segmentation and why it is called? So once you are marking that, when you are watching some videos on YouTube and your network is slow, what is happening? That means some of part of the video you are watching, then there is some buffering. That means there is a round like structure will move on the screen, which is called as buffering. Then after some time, some part of the video will play, then it is stopped there. Again, it is buffering. So why it is happening and how the part of the data is playing and again it is stopped. That means the data when we are, or the video we are playing, it is a huge amount of data, and when we are playing, it is downloaded. The video is downloaded from the server and we are watching it in online mode. So when we are watching the video or we are playing the video, some part of the video are downloaded and it is stored on the system and it is playing. But when it is, that part is completed, next part data, it is not present at that time. So it is waiting for the next part of the data. That means when we are downloading or transferring a big data, huge amount of data, if the media is not supported or the speed is not supported, then the data are transferred by, it is not transferred the entire data at the same time. It will move the data part by part. This part, that means the entire data will be divided into different parts, and each part is called as one segment. And this process is called as segmentation. So when we are downloading some video or some movies from online, from YouTube or some other sources to your system, it is taking some time. You can mark that, it may be 1 minute, 2 minute, 5 minutes, as per the capacity of the data, it is taking some more time. So what it will do? So when we're downloading, the entire data will be divided into different segments or different parts, and one by one part will be coming to my system when I am downloading. So once all the data or all the segments are coming to my system, again, it is joined in a sequential order so that I can get the entire data or total data. So this process of dividing the entire data into different segments or parts is called as the segmentation. And if the large data having different units of segmentation, one by one segment will be transferred, and at the destination location, again, the segments are arranged in a sequential order, and at the destination, we can get the total data. So this is the segmentation. And next, another term we are using in communication, that is called as multiplexing. So what is multiplexing? So basically in multiplexing, if you're watching the dish TV or cable TV in your home, you can find out you are having a single cable. It is connected to the service, either service provider or from your dish antenna to your setup box and setup box to your TV. So when you are changing the channels, you are able to view different channels. So how it is possible? With the same cable, you are watching different channels. Or another example, suppose you are from the online, you are listening some of the music, and at the same time, you are sending some data, or online you are doing some work. How both of the work will be done? Because we are taking a single internet connection to the system. That means multiple data are sent by the media at the same time. So the process of sending multiple tasks or multiple data in a single path, that is called as multiplexing. Suppose you are downloading two or three videos at a time. From any online server, you are downloading two or three videos at a time. Can you mark that some part of the first video will go to second video, or some part of the second video will forward to file three or video three? No. Why? Because at a time, all the three videos are downloading. In the same cable, all three videos data are coming. But video one data is coming to video one file. It is not going to video two or video three. Why it is coming? By the help of this multiplexing. We are multiplexed the data. So the first data is coming to video one. Second data is coming to video three. Third data is coming to video three. So we'll discuss how the data are coming, how the ports are connected, and how different designs are there for this purpose, so that we have to configure accordingly. So in a network also, if you're working on a big environment, suppose in an organization, you have three or four internet connections. For the uninterrupted internet service, you want to provide. But for the users, or the you are the network administrator there, and you have connected with four internet connections, you have to divide all the users so that each user having one main supply as well as one standby internet connectivity. Suppose you are having Jio as the first internet service, and you are having the second as BSNL as the second internet service. So for that user, if first internet connection will down or disconnected, immediately BSNL will start providing the data or carrying the data, so that user does not know whether the data is forwarded by using the first line or first ISP or second ISP. So we'll discuss these things after some practices and some of the discussions. We'll discuss it in the module 3, how the data or how the internet services will be connected, configured, and it will be also channelized. Suppose you are having some of the management level persons in a company, you are having 100 Mbps internet capacity. You want to provide a good data rate or bandwidth to the management level. So how you have to configure it so that group will get more internet connectivity and other users get less internet connectivity. As for the requirement, you can also configure it. So all the things we'll discuss, because this is the starting of our network, we have to learn more for this purpose. So we have to start the network. So we just know about the terms we are using in a network. So basically in a network, we know that we have to use the term sender, receiver, media, then some of the protocols we have to follow. So now we have to go for some of the hardware level of components or devices which we want to connect or create a network. Suppose I want to create a small network. So what are devices I need for a network? So these devices we have to discuss. So basically for that, we have to go for the components of network. So basically the component of network are like this. The first requirement is the end devices. The end devices means at the point the user is writing something or it is sitting and doing something. Okay, so these are the end devices. So suppose I am sending some data through my computer or through my mobile. So my mobile or my laptop is the end devices, and at the other end, to whom I am sending the data, at the device he will get the data, that is called as the end device. So at the both parts, the devices enter, sends and receives the data are called as the end devices. And next to the end devices, other devices are also called as intermediate devices. So basically, what are the intermediate devices? The most commonly we are using switch as the intermediate devices. Switches, routers, firewalls, checkpoints, and all other security devices are also part of these intermediate devices. Then third one is called as the media. So in a media or medium, as we have discussed, there are two types of media nowadays we are using. One is wired media and other one is wireless media. So we'll discuss the media in details. Next is the topology. As we have discussed, basically topology, it is the way in which we have to connect the device. So it is a designing structure. That means how we have to connect the device. So basically there are three basic ways or three basic topologies in which we have to connect the devices. These three types of topologies are bus, star, and ring topology. Bus topology, ring topology, and star topology. So out of these three topologies, we are using some other topology. These are called as mesh. Then there is a hybrid version like bus ring, then star ring, like this, some of the hybrid version of topology. But in computer network, we are using the topology that is the ring topology, sorry, star topology. Our switch is working on star topology. So we'll discuss only on star topology because switch is placed at the centralized location and all the end devices are connected to the switch. And last, we have discussed about the protocols. So protocols are the set of rules through which the data is forwarded from one device to other device. So this is just about what the components we have discussed in a network. We are using the network devices or network components are end devices, intermediate devices, media, topology, and protocols. So just for the time being, I'm using another diagram. So here, how to connect it, just I am showing you, it will take 2 to 3 minutes. So the software is called as packet tracer, through which we can discuss or we can do the labs in this packet tracer. So here we have to use the logical devices because physical devices we have to do it in our actual lab. But before going for the hardware version of the labs, first we have to practice in this software version, and the platform is packet tracer. So in this packet tracer, these are showing as the devices. So this is the, if you keep the cursor on this device, it will show you which device is it. Students, are you able to view the screen?
No, packet tracer? Sir, not visible.
Not visible.
No, sir.
Now is it visible?
Yes, sir. Now it is visible.
That packet tracer, white screen, it is showing or not?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
So in this screen at the top part, you can mark some of the devices. So when we are using it, we'll discuss. Just I'm doing some labs. Suppose I have a PC. This is a PC, and I have to take another PC. So this is my PC one, and this is my PC two. So this is the PC two, and this is my PC one. And I want to communicate between this PC one and PC two, between PC one and PC two. I want to connect. So how to connect a PC or laptop to other PC? So for that purpose, every PC having a single connector, which is called as the network connector, or there is a RJ45 type connector is available, which is having 8-pin connector. So I can take one cable. I have to connect at first PCs. This port is called as first Ethernet port, and it is connected to other PC at the same first Ethernet port. That means now my connection between PC one and PC two is established. But so I can transfer the data between PC one and PC two. Now I want to join another device, PC three. So it is having a single port. This is also having single port. So if I want to add some other devices in the network, so directly it is not possible. So how can I do it so that I can communicate among these three PCs? So what I have to do here, I have to take the help of another device that is called as the switch. So this is the switch, and by the help of, it is a 24 port switch. That means we can connect 24 devices through this switch. So how to connect it? Now I am connecting it. I have to connect. PCs are not directly connected to each other. All are connected through this intermediate device. So I have to connect between PC and switch. Then second device I have to connect through PC and switch. Third also PC to switch. So physically I have connected, because here there is some error is showing that because I have connected a wrong cable. So it is showing the cable I have used, this is wrong. In the first case, I have used the same cable between PC and PC. So I want to say that when we are connecting the devices in a network, there is some of the rules or some of the cables we have to follow. That means when we are connecting switch to PC or switch PC to PC or switch to switch, we have to go for a particular type of cable. So what are the types of cable, we'll discuss in media chapter. So I have to disconnect it, and I have to connect the right cable now. So this is called as the straight through cable. I have to connect the same ports of the switch and the PC. So you can find out that this is green mark, this is orange mark. So after some time, you can mark that this orange cables will automatically turns green. Either it turns green or it turns red. If it turns green, your cable is okay and your connection, physical connection is okay. Second PC is turned green. Now third also turned green. That means all the cables are right cables, but we have connected between PC and switch. So regarding this lab, and we have to do something more on this lab. So we'll continue the class because time is already 3 p.m. So we'll discuss in the next class. We'll continue the class. So for today, I'm stopping the class here. I'm closing the class here.
CCNA is for this semester only.
CCNA will take 4 semesters, 3rd, 4th, 5th and 6th.
Okay, sir. Means
so in these 4 semesters, we have to discuss all the 4 modules. So now Cisco has revised some of the syllabus. The 4 modules are now, it is available in 3 modules. So module 4, it is inbuilt with some of the module 2 and module 3. Anyway, the syllabus is same. We have to cover all the syllabus, but for the time being, we have divided into 4 parts. First, we have to divide and discuss about module 1, then 2, 3 is, as per Cisco, it is a single module, and fourth part is the separate module. So it will cover all the 4 modules, your 4 semesters. It will start from 3rd, 4th, 5th, and end at 6th semester. So with this, we have to discuss all the CCNA class, as well as we have to practice some of the labs also. And we have to go for the online test. At the end of each chapter, we have to go for the online test, and it is conducted by Cisco. So you have to appear the online test, and you can get the certificate also, which is important for you if you are going for this CCNA or any networking related jobs in future. So any doubt, any other doubt?
So sir, in 2 years of SSCPL, we will learn only CCNA.
Basically the CCNA, belongs to the Center of Excellence, and which is belongs to SSCPL.
Okay, sir.
Okay, thank you. Thank you all.